Aristotle defines human beings as rational animals. That is to say, we're animals, but we're animals of a very special kind. Because in addition to our various animal capacities, we also have this distinctive rational capacity that is unique to human beings. This idea contributes to a long-standing philosophical tradition of thinking about human nature as one part rational executive control and one part base animal impulse, so that the rational part of us has to keep constant vigilant watch over our animal impulses and to keep them in check. Plato, for example, talks about what happens when we allow the rational part of our soul to lapse. Then he says, the wild beast within us breaks free and commits all sorts of vile and wicked acts. Mary Midgley says that this myth of a beast within feeds into a related myth of a beast without, according to which wolves and other carnivores are manifestations of that vile and wicked animal impulse that we're only able to keep in check because of our rational capacities. But Midgley says, if you look at how animals actually behave in the wild, you'll find that no animal conducts itself in the way that Plato supposes. And if there's no such thing as a beast without, then maybe the beast within us is also
not so wild as all that.